Hey guys, it's me Teal. Today, as you can see by the title, we are making an elegant castle. So for this castle, I had a blue frozen castle before this, which you can check out in the top right corner. There will be an eye which will guide you to my elegant frozen castles, people, in case you want to see that before seeing this video. But anyways, the frozen slash snow season is like gone, long gone. Everybody pretty much just skipped over it. Like, most of the people I know just time travel to spring, and honestly I don't blame you. And some people are just hating on time traveling, but by now a lot of people time travel, and I'm not honestly mad. Like, right now I do time travel as well, because as you can see, I am in summer, and technically it is summer for the southern hemisphere, but I am in the summer season where I have my blue hydrangeas because my island is blue themed. Also, in this video I wanted to talk about my island and possibly flattening it after I'm done with my blue island, but don't worry, I will save a dream address and I will do a final tour before I'm done. But it's gonna take some time for me to finish, but after I'm done with that, I need some island theme suggestions. I wanted to do something spring related, but by the time I finish, I don't know if I'm even gonna be done with that or done with this island in the first place. So yeah. Also, in the last video that we did, you guys voted that you want a voiceover during the speed post, so I'm here to give you a voiceover. So enjoy my beautiful voice, thank you very much. And it's currently 1 a.m. whilst I'm recording this, and it's gonna be 1 a.m. whilst I upload this, which is fine because my sleep schedule is like honestly not okay, but that's fine. I mean, it's pretty normal for me to sleep at like 3 a.m. but that's just how I am. Don't come at me in the comment section. But yeah, for this castle, I wanted to have a walkway of statues. That's what we're building right now. And honestly, it's pretty simple when you think about it, but I kept contemplating, and I just wanted to show my indecisiveness, because honestly, this is what really goes into a speed build. It's not all like, oh, so I know that I'm gonna place this item here and this item here. This is literally the behind the scenes of me doing a speed build, and you might think that it barely takes me any time, but honestly, as compared to a lot of other creators, I take so much more time, and I'm fine with that because I'm just like relaxing, watching a YouTube video, probably an Animal Crossing YouTuber who's, I just like supporting other small creators like me, or just other Animal Crossing creators, or I watch random like video edits. I don't know, they kind of like goof me up, if that's even a word. But what was I even talking about? Yeah, I like relaxing and just doing my speed builds slowly, because when you take it too fast paced, you can get burnt out easily. That's happened to me before. I just went on a decorating spree in one day, and then like for like 4 or 5 days, I was like, I don't even want to touch Animal Crossing. Honestly, I spent so many hours into my island, and I haven't made that much progress, and that's because I've been playing the game, not playing it to decorate, but I've been playing the game just roaming around doing random unproductive stuff, just like me in real life. So it's not really me escaping to a virtual world, because I'm unproductive in both, but in a way it is. And honestly, Animal Crossing has changed my life, blah 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 blah, sappy speech which I don't want to speak about. So let's just talk about the build. So I'm placing 2 walls on either side of my castle, because I want to make 2 waterfalls leading into the lakes or rivers or whatever you want to call them that the statues are in, so that it looks more grand. And also, if you want to see me decorating and seeing what actually goes into the process and what I'm thinking about when I'm decorating something, or if you want to help me, or if you want to interact with me, you probably know what I'm gonna be talking about right now. But yeah, I have started streaming on Twitch, twitch.tv/teal_hawkyt. If you haven't followed me there already, go and follow me, because I've been putting a lot of effort into my streams. We got affiliate recently, which I'm really excited about, and you do not need to subscribe. You can just drop in for literally a minute. I can acknowledge you. We can talk for some time. And you can leave whenever you feel free to. Honestly, if you're decorating your island and you're bored, streamers and watching streamers are like the best way to go, honestly, for me. Like, it doesn't even have to be my stream necessarily, but it would be nice if it was my stream. But watching streamers while you're decorating, A, gives you inspiration and allows you to interact with like your favorite content creator or whatever. So I really like streaming. And it's like a way for me to not get bored whilst I'm playing Animal Crossing. So if you want to help me not get bored whilst I'm playing Animal Crossing, then just hop into a stream, say hi, or don't say hi and just be there lurking or doing whatever you want. But yeah, I love streaming. The Twitch community is honestly just so loving. I did stream some streams on YouTube, but honestly, the Twitch community is just insane. You guys should definitely get Twitch if you haven't already. I am telling you, it is so worth it. It's the same thing that I did with Discord. I literally didn't get Discord for such a long time, but now I own a server. And that server had like peaked one time, and we're like, I think we have like more than 100,000 messages on that server, which is insane. It's really insane. And we have like around 200 people. So yeah, if you want to join my Discord, it will be in the description, shameless plug, but that's okay because it's my channel, so I can be as shameless as I want. This is Teal Unfiltered. I was gonna say unplugged, but then I was like, that doesn't make sense. So then I said unfiltered. That's what I'm thinking about in my brain right now. Oh, this is our last build that we did. Link in the eye right now as well if you want to watch that. If you're interested in watching the fake bridge that I made. I honestly don't like calling it a fake bridge, but I don't know what else to call it. Like, what would you call that? I would call it fake bridge as well. I was thinking of calling it false perspective, but there's nothing really to perceive. Is that where perspective comes from? Is perceived the root? I don't want to talk about school, but there's nothing to like look at which is in a false perspective. Like, there's nothing which looks smaller or bigger or whatever. So it doesn't make sense to say it. But for me, it somehow reminded me of false perspective. Anyways, moving back to the build and my island. This build is kind of like a white, blue and pink color scheme. I really don't know what to call it. I thought that I was gonna go for like a Greek inspired island, but I don't think that it's like proper Greek, because I'm not going for like a Santorini Mykonos vibe, because that's a totally different vibe. I'm just going for teal core, which is blue elegant core. That's what I'm calling it, and that's just because I love decorating with blue. And honestly, it's just making me so happy. Before this, I had no theme in mind, and my island was just, okay, what are we doing with it? So yeah, I really like having a theme. It's totally fine if you don't have a theme. I wanted to make a separate video about like having a theme, not having a theme, what are the benefits. Let me know if you guys would be interested in that, because I don't know if you guys would be interested in that. But yeah, also let me know, as I mentioned before, let me know what island theme I should do after Galactic. Actually, no, wait, Galactic is staying. I'm not saying bye to Galactic. I'm just flattening my island. I honestly am not gonna restart my island because I can't lose Galactic. There's literally no way that I put 900 hours into this island and I'm restarting. Honestly, I can't lose my villagers. It's just too hard to say goodbye. But I was thinking of getting a second switch, and I honestly might just do it. Because why not? You only live once, and I've been wanting a second switch for a really long time to have a second island. So yeah, I'm excited to do that if that happens. But yeah, other than that, I will now let you just hear the music for some time, because I don't have any conversation topic to talk about, but I'll pop in whenever I can. People that you broke me. And maybe you did. And maybe you did. But I'm not over it.
how the hell do I get over this? You said you made a mistake. Then you walked away. But when you have my hand under the vintage sign, I knew it wouldn't last. I knew it'd come undone. But when you held my hand under the vintage sign, I almost lost myself.
Okay, I'm back. So now to talk about the castle. I'm using a mixture of the lighthouses, and I also think that I use some silos in between. But adding structures which are extremely tall are crucial to your build to have different heights. Having grand structures include height as well as design slash texture. I honestly think that height plays a major role in castles because they're supposed to be these grand structures which really don't look like life size. And grand structures like the street organ or whatever the item is called, or the lighthouse, are not usually supposed to be items that you just have randomly. So I think it gives the effect that this is supposed to be like something which you don't see normally, which is the castle, which is the vibe that I'm going for. I said witches probably 700 times. Oh my god, I'm thinking of witches now. Like W-I-T-C-H-E-S. Wow, he can spell. But over here, I'm placing these simple panels, which I ended up changing to this really beautiful window, glass window design, which I honestly loved, and it made me feel like it was more magical and like a castle. And then I tried using these telephone booths, but it didn't work. But now I'll just let you watch and hear more of the music.
From your telescope, take me on this journey home. I don't wanna wait no more. Lay me down behind the moon. Tell me you'll be on the soon. I don't wanna wait no more. We could be dancing in the stars. We could be floating all the way. As long as I'm safely in your arms. And it don't really matter where we stay. Cause space makes me sad.
I really feel like custom designs can make or break your build. Honestly, having custom designs can just improve your builds drastically to another level. And honestly, use up all the spaces that you have. Don't wait to get spaces, because you can always delete codes to get new ones if you find better ones. But just use all the ones you have. Even if you're like proud of a design, supposing you made, which I literally have right now, so I'm not setting a good example of what I'm saying. Like, I teach by bad example. But honestly, just upload it and then delete it if it's something which is not important. Or something that you won't use on your island, if you can let go of it. And if you don't need to have the actual design with you, just upload it and then be done with it. Because you do not know the power of custom designs. It can honestly save you so much. I know that a lot of people use either the 9-part or the plus 9 plus 10 11 12 13 14 15 yeah 9 part or 15 part the part which is a part, if you don't know, it's a part which can just connect with each other, and it comes in different variants, and a lot of islands have it. And the thing is, it's really good because you can always switch it out with custom designs, because you'll have the same blocking, so you can always switch up your island theme just like that, and you won't have to change like that much, which is honestly good. But for an island like mine, I don't think the path would be that useful. But I did download this diagonal kind of path today, which I'm really excited to use in the future. And I think that that's gonna just elevate my builds a lot. I can't wait for you guys to see it. But honestly, custom designs are crucial. And if you don't have Nintendo Switch Online, just make your custom designs. They can honestly just improve your builds so much. And that's what I had to say, because I was just like thinking about the custom designs in this build, and I wanted to speak about that. Anyways, see the video now. Over here, I am just placing some more Valiant statues, the best statues in the game. And I made an Instagram post like some time ago, recently. And I was just talking about how statues in the game just make the game so much more beautiful. And especially the Valiant statues and like the grand statues, honestly, they're literally a piece of art. And they're famous for a reason. I actually don't know why they're famous. I don't know the reason. But they look so, so majestic, so elegant. And I just love incorporating these, again, like I said, grand elements into my build. I feel like the statues just elevate it and make it look like it's a proper entrance, or is like looking so majestic in a way. I'm blanking out now. But yeah, I'm including this wedding arch because I couldn't find any other white arch, and the pink flowers kind of look cute. It kind of contrasted and was like a break from all the blues, and the green was matching the floor slash the hedges. And also, I didn't speak about the hedges much, but it was fun to use the hedges because this is a summer themed island. To switch it up and have some green was nice. That is all I have for you guys today. I hope you guys liked this video. I put a lot of effort into it and making this castle. Remember to catch me live on Twitch and join my Discord. Anyways, you can go to my channel and check out any of my videos if you're ever bored, and DM me on Instagram if you're bored again. I don't mind talking to you guys. I'd love to get to know you, and I will see you next time.